So, allow me to share my screen. All right, let me go to Spoken Exam. Because we want to ensure the session can run smoothly. Because unfortunately, the spectrum is still down. Let me check whether it is still down or it's quite slow. So let's use Spectrum Exam as well. So let's pick one of the course. You can open your screen and also maybe you can follow on because when you open your screen, you might not able to see my streaming. So one of the way you can use your mobile phone to stream the session, and you can use your PC or laptop to follow along, or vice versa, you can use your phone to follow along. Alright, so I'm going to use the Spectrum Exam, but you can use Spectrum if at your site the Spectrum is working well. So definitely, ultimately, this is going to be used in Spectrum for the purpose of attendance taking. Right, pick any of the active course that you are in charge currently. Right, and for the attendance, if it is not yet there, you can add it by ensure it is turned edit on, and then add activity or resources here and look for attendance. Here, this is attendance. Again, I repeat, go to your course, go to the front page of your course, and then normally at the top topic, I think the first one, you add the activity. We're going to add attendance. So look for this attendance and then add. So you might want to give this a name, attendance for semester 1, 2021, 2022. You can put a description there if you like. If your course involve multiple groups, meaning multiple departments or multiple faculties, you can separate the attendance if you like, or you can combine them together. It is right over here. You can put restriction here. No, not this one. Let me check. Common module setting. So this one. Show on calls, right over here, group mode. Notice in our previous session, I mentioned there are three group modes, right? One is no group, separate group, visible group. If you want this particular attendance to only be allocated for certain group, then you can use separate group. Let's say this is only meant for group A and B. Right? Remember we have group A, B, C just now, right? And then I do grouping. So the purpose of grouping is to group certain groups into a bigger group. So let's say I want to have group A and B. Let's say I'm teaching group A and B, and I will be using group A and B. What happened? The students under this group, when they are taking the attendance, they will be using this one. And then, so this is group A and B. I might want to put at the top here, group A and B. Like that. here I can put restrict access only to group AB. That's it. Save and return the course. That's when if your course have more than one group. But majority of us, if we only handling maybe 40 students, we can simply do this simple attendance. Same 1, 20, 21, 20. So you don't have to do any other setting, just as it is safe. So majority of us will be using this one. This is for those who are having multiple group in their course. Multiple group at the beginning. That means when you assign the course, that course have multiple lecturers, and you are supposed to teach group A, for example. Then this is the way to go lah. If your course only you and your constructor teaching, and you don't want to separate to a separate group, then you can use this approach, the simplest one. Just create attendance. Let's see the simplest part first. We come to this later. Go there. We can by default there is no session added. Session meaning your when your class is going to happen. So currently there are none. So let's add session. Let's say your class start every Monday for the period of 14 weeks. Or maybe now we are on week 6, right? Is it week 6? Week 6, yeah. So you can, let's say our class on every, today is Wednesday, right? Wednesday. And it start from 10 to 12, for example. Here is the trick. You don't have to create every time. You just need to create one time. So throughout the semester, the session already there. So you need to use multiple session here. So repeat the session above. So we're going to repeat this for the for every Wednesday. Repeat once a week, and repeat until when. So we can pick this calendar until next year, I think somewhere in January. Maybe this one, 26. So what happened, it will create the session starting from today, next week, until this day. Right? If you're not using this multiple session, it will only create one session. So next week you have to create again. The following week you have to create again. Such a tedious work. So by doing this, using this multiple session, it will simplify your attendance taking. Do remember to allow students to record their own attendance, because now we are online. Most of us are doing online. So this is, I think, a must for you to take. And then I click add. So see, I've created all the remaining weeks. And when the times come, the student will be taking the attendance. Let me go to the front page. Okay, AB4005 for this one. If I change my role as student, switch role is for you to see how the students are going to see when they enter the your Spectrum course page. You pick student, so now your role as a student. So you see, this is the attendant. So that is how it looks like. So the things that not happening yet, a student certainly not able to record attendance. Things that currently happening within the time window of the class, the one we specify the timing just now, when the times come, it will active and student able to record the attendance. So I'm going to record my attendance here. So saying that I'm present, just changes. Let me log in as one of student here to show that. ID for the file. Let's see, I'm looking as Ismail. Oops, I need to change my role. Wait, look for Ismail. Where is Ismail just now? Never mind. Muhammad Azim. We pick different person. Azim. This is a student coming in. They record the attendance. Submit attendance. 100%. Oops. By right, there will be attendance recorded. But somehow we have database problem. So that's how the student able to record the attendance. So let's see the summary of the attendance. So I'm taking this as an example. My course KIB405. I have that set. And then what happened? If I click on the report, the way to get here is just click on this link, click there, and then it will be directed you to this page, and then click on report, and then you see your student name and also the status. You can download this report, you can export it, and then you get downloaded. I have downloaded just now. So this is the report that we have so far up to the week 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you know who are the students missing in action. So with a question mark, meaning that the student is not attend to your class. So you can do analysis from this sheet, and then you'll be able to take certain action so that you know maybe the student having problem and so on. So again, so far I've covered how we can create the attendance by first looking at the simplest way. Let me open that page. I think I used this one just now. KIB405. Sorry for keep jumping. The simplest one is when you are teaching a course, only one big group there. You can simply create attendance. And then for you to automatically create the multiple session, what you can do, I need to log in back by as instructor. Wait, come back here, get a default user file. This is the attendance that I created. Remember just now I add session automatically. The way to add session automatically, you specify the time of the class, the date, the time, and also use this multiple session. So click repeat, and the class happen on, let's say, on every Monday, then every Monday, on every Tuesday, Wednesday, then you make it every Wednesday, and then repeat every 1 week, and then put up the stop date until end of the semester, which is on end of January. So by doing so, it will, when you click add, it will pop up all the session for you. Let me show all. So all the session. All right. Any questions so far? Now let me check the chat box. Oh, Mumtaz, Dr. Mumtaz. I already asked the question just now and you already answered. Oh, okay. They all say Spectrum website is running. Okay, again, seeing the Spectrum is running quite slow. We use Spectrum exam for the purpose of today's training. Hopefully, PTM will be able to resolve very soon. And then we'll be able to make use of our teaching and learning Spectrum. Right. Any other question? Okay, we have Dr. Simon. How do you allow students to record attendance using QR code? Okay, good question. If you want your student to record using QR code, for example, they log in to the page, your Spectrum page, course page, and then they will see the QR code at the right side, right? So you can do so. Let me go to the front page of my course by clicking on the code. Currently, I do not have that QR code yet. Hopefully, in Spectrum Exam also have that functionality. Let me see whether I have it. I'm trying to add that block. Let me see. Okay, luckily it is there. So again, I repeat, turn edit on, you need to add that block, the QR code block. Over here, the things that we have over here, we call it block. This one, this is block, and so on. So currently we do not have that attendance QR code block yet. So if it is not there, just turn edit on and then over your mouse at the add block and then look for the QR code. Once you click on that, it will bring to that site. You might want to rearrange it to the top. Now, this one, the current QR code will correspond to this attendance, right? If it is not what it's supposed to be, then you need to go here, configure QR code, and then specify which session that QR code is representing. So far, you have to do this selection manually. So that means if the next class, the next Wednesday, you need to open it quickly and then configure to that particular week. And then what happened? When the student scan that code, it will record attendance. Then student have to use the Moodle app. They have to log in as a student using their ID, and then they will be able to record this attendance. That's how you can use the QR code. And all the attendance will be pulled to the session that it assigned to. Let's say this assigned to this session, one of the session, and then it will get recorded here. So while you are in the class, at the beginning of the class or maybe at the middle, you want to quickly check who are attending your class and also have recorded the attendance. You can do so by going to that attendance. Let me show you. Just go there and then look for the current class. Today is 24. Okay, this one. And then you'll be able to see the summary. Who currently present and who are not yet recorded the attendance, because in our most of us will be using MS Team, you'll be able to see who are in your session, right? and then minus your name, it will be, for this case, it will be 20. So you know that your class 40, for example, then that's mean another 20 missing. And then 20 should have recorded their attendance. Then you can check over here, you should expect there are 20 students present. But if you only see 5, that means 10% have not yet recorded their attendance. The important thing here is for you to see the report. Right? This report will allow you to see who are frequently not attend to your class. And then that will be giving you earlier a signal that this student might have a problem because he or she not attend to your class. So let's see if you have any other question. I'll try to address that.
Hi, Dr. Yazid. So how can we download this attendance list? No?
All right. You can download by, let me go back to the front page, show you from the beginning. So let's say this is the one that they're using. And then notice over here at the top there are tabs. You have report. Report is for you to see on the screen. If you want to have these items be downloaded, you go to this next step, export. Okay. And then over here, you can click OK, and then it will download it for you. Notice over there, the new.
Okay, so you decide from which date to which date now.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. Any other question?
Thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, let's see on the grouping. This one, let's see whether it is working. Alright, let's say we want it to be for group A. And then, sorry, add session. I should use add session. Okay. First, of course, you need to have the session added. So remember, I picked this attendance for group A and B. So I leave it group A and B there. And then again, you can create multiple session from today, and it happens every Wednesday, and then it lasts until January end. And then remember to allow student to record on attendance. And then and then we click add. So I haven't clicked selected. So this one. All right, like before, it will create for us. So here for group A, and here for group B, and here for all. Remember, this attendance we set earlier on only for group A and B. That's why when you select all, only A and B are listed down. And then you can make use of this. Let's say, yeah, when the student comes in, okay, they will, group A and B will be using this one. The other one will not be active because we all have a restriction. Imagine that they are not seeing this one lah, because now we consider the student have group A, B, and then C and D. Let me create another one. So that it is complete. Then there's C and D. So this is separate group, and then looking, I choose C and D. All right. We can display access to only group C and D. C and D. Save and return. So notice this is for A, B, and this is for C, D. I haven't created for C, D. Their session. Just repeat the procedure that I did just now. I select this group, and then it happened on that day. Maybe it happened on the day after. So every Thursday, one week, allow them to record. Okay. So. Oops. Oh, I haven't clicked this. Until and generally. So it created for group C and D. And if I go back to the front page of the course, I'll see that setting. So when student group C join in, they will be able to see this. They will be able to accept this. Alright, any question? Let me see the chat. Let us know what do you think about this program. Oh, that one is feedback. Oh, Izati here. Is it possible to get the recording for... Yeah, possible. You know, you actually join to this team. You'll be able to revisit back this team, and then you'll be able to see the recorded recorded video. Any other thing that I haven't uncovered? Remember, you need to configure this block to correspond. This code to correspond to your attendance of the day. Right, so you need to choose the correct one. But I think for online, they simply click on this and then record the attendance from there. This is useful if you are in physical class, the QR code. All right, I think we stop here. Oh, we have one question. You can access the recordings from file session in Teams. Any other question? I'm reading the our meeting chat. Is it possible to get the recording? Okay, possible. All right. If there's no question, thank you very much for the for your attention and for participating in this session. So I think in upcoming week there will be a session one-on-one, Spectrum 101 on quiz, how to create quiz and how to create question bank that will be given by Dr. Zahir. So please alert on emails and then do register on that. That might be very handy or very useful for you to assess your student because it will make your life very, very easy because you can automatically assess your student by using quiz. By the way, just now in our previous try run on group setting for assignment, but if you remember, we not able to get the group number here. And then I mentioned that we need to use grouping, right? So I just set to have a grouping, and then we'll be able to see that group. What happened if you did not create group, but create grouping, and you have so many groups, and you have one group where it contains everyone, the system will get confused because they do not know how this quiz or this assignment is going to group the student. So that's why you need to use grouping if you have such case. So to show you the scenario, let me go back here. Open need that. This is related to the previous grouping session. Just want to highlight the setting that need to be done. So group. When we set assignment and then set group, group assignment, for example, I mean, you want your student to submit their work in group. If you have this scenario, if you have so many group created and you have one group contains everybody, and then this group contains certain student and so on, the assignment just now, the one you created, will get confused. It do not know which group it's supposed to pick in creating the assignment. So that's why you need to use grouping. So obviously in our case, I want the student to work in their assignment in the form of group A, B, C, and D. And therefore, I create grouping for that particular group. Grouping A, B, C, and D. So in the assignment setting, let me go to the front page of this course. Open that. The setting that I created just now for this group assignment. In the setting, I need to make sure this one, I cannot choose none because the system will get confused. So I need to specify which grouping for this particular assignment. So if I choose this, what happened? This assignment will expect to have four group, which coming from this grouping lah. So if you do this way, then you are you are fine. The beauty about this approach, afterwards, when students submit, you only have to mark four assignment, and then all the comments will be relayed to your students at one go. Due to the time limitation, I am not able to show in details, but it really helped you in organizing your class when it involved many students. All right. I think I'll stop here. Thank you for your time and participation. Thank you.
Dr. Yazid, ada satu soalan.
Ada lagi soalan?
Mr. Simon.
Okay. So, I missed just now. Is QR code only for physical class? QR code suitable for physical class. If you want to use in your online class, fine, we can use it, but you need to make sure. Let me go to the QR code. You need to make sure you check out this down below here, whether it corresponds to your current class or not. If not, you need to configure and pick the one that corresponds to the current class, which can be quite difficult if you have multiple groups. What happened in the class, in the online class, student will have access to the spectrum, right? Student therefore have access to this link. Right, student A and B, group A and B, they will go here, and then they will click on, let me again behave like a student here. Let me try looking as Tan Yi Heng. Okay, this attendant. This student belongs to C and D, that's why he can access this. The class for C and D happens tomorrow. That's why he or she cannot record attendance. Let me pick those who are in A and B. Let me log out first. So I'm showing you on the student side how they see the attendance in your course page and how they record the attendance. I'm going to this course. I need to choose student who are in group A or group B. Let's see. Group A. Okay, diving link. And let me log in. This function is only available for manager. At your site, you don't have this function. Now, since this student in group A and B, he can go there. And then, what happened? Is the time pass? Okay, now 11:38. Let me check the setting. So, students should be able to click this link and then record their attendance. I think something wrong with the setting. So that's how the student will be able to record the attendance by directly using the link over here. So any other question? Is the QR code for the, okay, that one I answered. Try to check this. I need to change my role as instructor. And then on the course, group A and B, alright. This one. Today is Wednesday. Oh, the timing. The timing is wrong. Let me check. It should be from 10 to 12. Very important to make sure the date of the class is set properly. 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Otherwise, your student not able to record the attendance. Group A. Alright, so let's check again. Group A. Group A. Now you can record the attendance. Go here. And then save changes. Alright. So any other things? Any other question? If not, we stop here. Remember, you can access to our session by coming back to this team, and then you'll be able to access the recorded. Or alternatively, EDEC will email the links to all of the participants. I believe we have all your emails. All right, thank you very much. Remember to send out the fill out the feedback. Linda, we have submitted the feedback
over here, right? Yes, we have right. Shared in the chat area. So thank you, Dr. Yazid.
Thank you,
everyone, for staying.
Can I ask for the QR code?
Sorry?
Can I ask about the QR code? The QR code for the attendance, is it that we can only create it manually one by one for each day or each session? Can we auto-create it to apply for all the different weeks or different sessions that we have and apply auto-apply it to all the different groups of students that we have? Is that possible?
I'd love to have that. I'm still searching for that. Currently, unfortunately, we have to do it manually.
So at the moment, everything have to be manually one by one, and then
yeah, because at, if you can see, when I hover my mouse here, every student will see one QR code over here. Where is the QR code? Gone. 4005.
So the QR code will be for that particular session for that one day, right?
Yes. Correct.
So we have to create one by one manually for each one, and if there are different batch of students, then it will be one by one created.
You just need to change the session. Because it happened on certain time period, right? So use that time period. That means beginning of the class, you just quickly check whether it is correspond to the session or not.
So means every day still have to update the QR code manually one by one every
day.
That's
why I'm showing you just now. The student should able to use this link instead. So you don't have to worry about that QR code. Student use this link, they click on that, and then they will click on submit attendance. That's it. Because when they if you want them to use QR code, they have to use the browser, they have to use their phone. That would be quite multitasking work.
If they say using the link means that they no need to be physically there, they also can submit the attendance, right?
Yes. They now because most of us are doing online, right? So that's why in the setting just now, we allow students to submit their record their attendance.
Okay, so this one is more for the virtual or the hybrid session, right? It's not for the physical one.
Yeah. If for physical, then you untick the student allow to record the attendance just now, and then you can use the QR code. And then again, as of now, I could not find the automation on that. You still have to click manually. Hopefully, if there's any new update on that, we will update our spectrum to use that automation.
Okay.
Thank you. So thank you, everyone. Take care. I'm trying to stay here for a few more minutes. If you have questions, I'll more than happy to answer those questions.